The one that you love hasn't changed. It's just one of them days. 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 It's just one of them days.
Hello, you guys. So, welcome back to my channel. Today I am making a new wig review for my Summer Blonde series, and I am currently rocking this beautiful blonde bombshell by Sensationnel, and it is part of the Dream Mew series. It is called the Joanne wig, and this is what the card looks like. Yes, yes, yes. It's in the color T427613, and it is a Swiss lace front wig, and it's a synthetic wig, and I'll leave the link to it down below. I copped this wig like a couple weeks ago, and at first, I'm not gonna lie, I was a little discouraged because I was not customizing it the way that I wanted to look. I got this wig from a beauty, well, I saw it at a beauty supply store for $80, and I was like, I can't afford that right now. So I just took a picture of it in the little product card, and I decided I would just buy it online. I found it online for like $40 something, so it was a lot cheaper than what they were selling it for at the beauty supply store. So I ended up copping this wig, and it's so funny because the mannequin head in the beauty supply store, it looks nothing like what it looks like on my head, and I guess I'll put in a picture of what it looks like at the beauty supply store here. Nonetheless, I still love the wig. I have grown to love it because I didn't like it at first. Well, at least not on me, I didn't like it at first. But now I am actually feeling this wig. It's really cute. It's definitely giving summertime vibes, and it was very easy to blend. I will say that it was very easy to blend, and I think that pretty much has to do with the fact that it's a Swiss lace front wig. So this wig, I'll go through the general gist of it. So like I said, it was a Swiss lace front wig. It's also a synthetic wig, and it's in the color T427613. And honestly, like, the curls weren't as big and fluffy as they are right now, and that's because I went through and I brushed it out with a paddle brush, because at first it was kind of giving me ramen noodle vibes and I was just not feeling it. So I went through and brushed it out. At first I was like, when I was brushing it out, I was like, I don't know how I'm feeling about it, but I kept going. I was just like, okay, I'm kind of feeling it. And then I also went in and trimmed the ends off because it was a lot longer than this, but I decided it would look a little bit better. It was a little bit shorter. It came down to about right here. So I cut it to about right here. So a couple of inches I chopped off because I felt like it would look better. I'm sorry if I sound like I'm in a rush, because I actually am in a rush. I have to be somewhere in like 20 minutes and my camera is about to die. So if it sounds like I'm trying to chuck through this review, that's because I am. So please bear with me. But yeah, so I did chuck off a little bit of inches off of the wig. I did go through and create some baby hairs throughout the wig. But the wig did come with baby hairs already. I just decided it wasn't a lot, so I just went in and made some of my own. It also came as a middle part wig, as you can see like on the little product card, but I decided that it looked better on me as a side part. And luckily enough for this kind of wig, the lace goes pretty far. I don't think it goes from ear to ear, and I'll start a video clip of how far it goes, but it gives enough lace for you to be able to part it in any kind of way that you want, whether it's a middle part or a side part. It definitely gives you the flexibility to do so. So I do like that about the wig, that it comes with a lot more lace than lace front wigs usually come with. And the Swiss lace, I love Swiss lace front wigs. I think I've decided that they're my favorite because they're so like easy to blend. Like, it doesn't take a lot to blend them. The only thing I would have done differently in terms of me customizing was maybe pluck at the hairline a little bit more, because I mean, I just didn't have time, so I had to make it do what it do. But that's one thing I would have done differently. And I didn't really do anything to the part at all. I didn't pluck it. The only thing I did was add concealer, and some powder to the part to blend it in, and that was all I did. Because other than that, like, the parting space is bomb in this wig, so I didn't really have to do a lot. I love the color, of course. The color is definitely the selling point. Like, I like how it transitions from the brownish black color down to this very vibrant blonde color. And I also like how full this wig is. Like, it doesn't feel thin or skimpy. It feels full, but it's not heavy, which I do appreciate. And I just like the curl and bounce to it. It's just such a perfect summer wig. That's how far it comes down. So I would definitely recommend this wig. I had to do, you know, some customization to it to make it fit me. But other than that, I mean, I didn't really have to do too much to the wig because it was pretty much a really good looking wig from jump. So this is a pretty short and sweet and simple wig review. I hope you guys don't mind that. But I will leave the link to this wig down below, and definitely subscribe, turn on your notifications, and stay tuned for more wigs that are coming to my summer blonde wig series. And I will see you guys in the next upload. Bye.
I sit alone minding my business, but you ain't with it. I know you want to check up on me, but today I don't.